Well, good Wednesday morning, everyone, and good to see you. Thanks for tuning in. We are shifting gears today because for the today and tomorrow, I wanted to share with you what happened at church the first Sunday in February. And we had a special Sunday. We call them special because we just do different fun stuff on that first Sunday. This coming Sunday, we're going to do one called Maranatha Music Sunday, and you're going to hear all about that on Friday. But anyway, we had God Loves You Sunday, and we had special things all over the place showing, just symbolizing God's great love for us. The Bible says God is love, and He is love personified. And we wanted to celebrate that He loves you and me so very much. And we did that. And I want to share it with you because it's just a point I want to drive home so much. You can't ever say it too much, too much. Let me give you a verse for the day. Romans 5, verse 8. You see, talk is cheap. God can say He loves us. But just like when you say that you love somebody, it's easy to say, sometimes it's harder to do, but not for God. In fact, just so that we can be clear on that, Paul wrote in Romans chapter 5 at verse 8, he said, God demonstrates His own love. He demonstrates it. He shows it for us in this, that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Wow. Isn't that something? That's the greatest gift He could possibly show us. That He demonstrates His love. He shows it to you and I that Christ died for us. And of course, the most famous verse in the Bible, John 3:16, says it in another way. For God so loved the world, He gave His one and only Son, that what? Whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. You want everlasting life? All you have to do is accept God's love for you and place your faith in Him. You can't earn your way to heaven. But you can follow God's plan, which is just to love Him. Love Him back, really. He already demonstrated His love for you. All you have to do is in turn demonstrate your love for Him by placing your faith in Him. Well, we had a wonderful worship set that last February 6th. And that's what I want to share with you today and tomorrow, actually, with a different song tomorrow. But our worship leader, David Green, and his worship team did a wonderful job of driving God's love home to us. You see, words sometimes speak to the head. Music has a way of what? Speaking to your heart. And in today's show, you're going to hear a song that I know you know. I don't care. Maybe you haven't been in church in 50 years. I know you know this song. And I'm going to let David introduce it for us. And then tomorrow I'll be back and we're going to have another great song about God's love for you. Enjoy the rest of the show. And I'll see you tomorrow.
How many of you, as kids, think way back? It's the same for me, I have to think way back too. Went to Sunday school. All right, see, I love that. And for those that don't raise your hand, I get it. You know, there are people that, you know, they're 50, they're 60, 70, 80. They find Jesus at that time in their lives. But for those that went to Sunday school, and maybe for those that didn't, you might even recognize this song. And I just thought it would be kind of nice just to think back that love that we remember Jesus happened for us as kids as we sang that. And with the trust of children, so let's sing Jesus Loves Me. Jesus loves me, this I know.
Jesus to Calvary did go.